Shortcut method for factorization of quadratic polynomial. Let us learn how to factorize quadratic polynomial quickly. See here, take an example, factorize x square plus 5x plus 6. Now the coefficient of x square is 1, that is 1x square. The coefficient of middle term is 5, this is 5x. Plus 6. Now the first step is multiply the coefficient of first term, that is coefficient of x square, that is 1, into the constant term, that is plus 6. Multiply 1 and plus 6, that is equal to 1 into plus 6 is plus 6. Now you have to find two numbers such that their product is plus 6 and their sum is the coefficient of the middle term, that is plus 5. Find two numbers such that their sum is plus 5 and their product is plus 6. Now look at the factors of 6. 6 can be written as 3 into 2. And 6 can be written as 6 into 1. Only in these two ways you can write 6. So, out of these two, which pair we have to take so that their sum is plus 5 and product is 6. The product of these two pairs is 6. Out of these two, sum of which one is plus 5? That is 3 plus 2 is equal to plus 5. So we can write 3 and 2. Now put the sign plus 3 plus 2 because we have to get plus 5 here. And the product also plus 6. So plus into plus is plus. Now see here, plus 3 into plus 2 is plus 6. Plus 3 plus 2 is equal to plus 5. So we got the numbers. Now right here, we got two numbers, plus 3 and plus 2, such that their product is plus 6, sum is plus 5. Now the coefficient of x square is 1 here, right, divided by 1 here, because this is the coefficient of x square. Now the next step is we can write the factors. Start from the denominator, that is 1, and variable in the equation is x, so 1x plus the numerator. And here also, denominator is 1, coefficient is, variable is x plus numerator. So the factors are x plus 3 and x plus 2. This is the shortest method for factorizing x square plus 5x plus 6. Let us see one more. X square minus 5, 7x plus 6. Factorize x square minus 7x plus 6. Look at the coefficient of x square, that is 1, into constant term, that is plus 6. So 1 into plus 6 is plus 6. This is the first step. Then you have to find two numbers. You have to find two numbers such that their product is plus 6 and their sum is minus 7. Their sum is minus 7, which is the coefficient of the middle term. Now, 6 can be written as 6 into 1 and 6 can be written as 3 into 2. 6 into 1 is 6, 3 into 2 is 6. Out of these two, you have to find the numbers whose sum is 7. Here 6 plus 1 is 7. So 6 plus 1 is 7. But we want this sum minus 7. So you have to put minus minus. Minus 6 minus 1 is equal to minus 7. Minus 6 into minus 1 is equal to plus 6. Now we got two numbers, minus 6 and minus 1 divided by the coefficient of x square, that is 1. Here also write 1, the coefficient of x square. Now we will get the last step, that is factors. Denominator 1, variable x, and then numerator, that is minus x. Denominator 1, variable x, then numerator minus 1. So x minus 6 and x minus 1 are the factors of x square minus 7x plus 6. Now factorize x square minus x minus 6. Coefficient of x square is 1 into constant term, that is last term, is minus 6. 1 into minus 6 is minus 6. Find two numbers such that their product is minus 6 and their sum is minus 1. Write the factors of 6, that is 3 into 2, and 6 can be written as 6 into 1. See here, the product should be minus 6. So one of the two numbers should be minus, negative number. To get the product minus 6, two numbers should have the opposite sign. One is plus, another one is minus, or one is minus, another one is plus. In this case, find two numbers such that their product is 6 and their difference is 1. Product is 6, 3 into 2 is 6, and their difference is 1, that is 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. If I take 6 and 1, their product is 6, but their difference is 5. So since the product is negative here, we will get numbers with opposite signs. If the numbers have opposite signs, then while finding the sum, you have to subtract. So difference of 3 and 2 is 1. Now put the sign. Bigger number should have the negative sign because it is minus 1 you should get. So minus 3 plus 2. Now minus 3 into plus 2 is minus 6. Minus 3 plus 2 having opposite sign. So subtract 3 minus 2, 1. Bigger number sign, that is minus. So we got the two numbers, that is minus 3 and plus 2. Divided by the coefficient of x square, that is 1, here also 1. Now write the factors. Start from the denominator 1, variable x, then numerator minus 3. Start from the denominator, variable x here, then numerator plus 2. Next one. Factorize 6x square plus 5x minus 6. The first step is multiply the coefficient of x square, that is 6, into constant term, that is minus 6. 6 into minus 6 is minus 36. And here you have to write the coefficient of the middle term, that is plus 5 in this question. Now the next step is write the factors of 36. 6 x are 36. Twelve 3s are 36. 18 2s are 36. 9 4s are 36. 36 ones are 36. Out of these, 6 into 6, 12 into 3, 18 into 2, 9 into 4, 36 into 1. We will get the product 36. Now since the sign is minus here, see here, you should get minus 36. So you have to find two numbers such that their product is 36 and their difference is plus 5 because here the product is minus and you will get opposite sign here. Find two numbers such that their product is 36 and their difference is 5. Difference should be 5. Now 6 minus 6 0, 12 minus 3 is 9, 18 minus 2 is 16, 9 minus 4 is 5. So you have to write 9 and 4. Now you should get plus 5. So bigger number should have plus sign and opposite sign for another number, that is minus 4. Now plus 9 into minus 4 is minus 36. Plus 9 minus 4 is equal to plus 5. 9 minus 4 is 5. Bigger number sign is plus. Now we got two numbers, that is plus 9 and plus 9 and minus 4. Plus 9 and minus 4. Now divide by the coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square is 6 here. Here also divide by the coefficient of x square, that is 6. Now 3 3s are 3 2s are, that is plus 3 by 2. 2 2s are 2 3s are, that is minus 2 by 3. Now start from the denominator, that is 2. Here variable is x, 2x. Then numerator, that is plus 3. Here also start from the denominator 3, variable is x here, 3x, minus 2. So factors of 6x square plus 5x minus 6 are 2x plus 3 and 3x minus 2. 2x plus 3 into 3x minus 2 is equal to 6x square plus 5x minus 6. Now factorize 6x square plus x minus 2. First step is multiply the coefficient of x square and the constant term, that is minus 2. 6 2s are 12. Here plus into minus is minus. Now you have to find two numbers such that their product is minus 12 and their sum is the coefficient of the middle term, that is coefficient of x is plus 1. Find two numbers such that their product is minus 12 and their sum is plus 1. Now write the factors of 12. 6 2s are 12. 4 3s are 12. 12 1s are 12. Now out of this, since the product is negative here, you have to find two numbers such that their product is 12 and their difference is 1. Out of this, which one, out of these, which one is having difference 1? 6 minus 2 is 4, that is not possible. 4 minus 3 is 1. 12 minus 1 is 11, this is not possible, so you have to write 4 and 3. So here you should get plus 1, so bigger number should have positive sign and another number negative. Now plus 4 into minus 3 is minus 12. Plus 4 minus 3 is equal to plus 1. So we got two numbers, that is plus 4 and minus 3, divided by the coefficient of x square, that is 6. Here also 6. 2 2s are 2 3s are, that is plus 2 by 3. Here 3 1s are 3 2s are, that is minus 1 by 2. So the factors of 6x square plus x minus 2 is, start from the denominator 3, variable x plus 2. Here start from the denominator 2, variable x minus 1. So 3x plus 2 into 2x minus 1. Check out these answers with the factors we got by using factor theorem. That is previous method we have learned. This is the shortcut method to factorize quadratic polynomial.